Today our agenda is address resolution protocol. How to craft address resolution protocol header. So let's see our detailed agenda here. What is ARP? What are all fields exist in ARP packet header? How to craft ARP packet by using Python, by using SCAPY module, demo, what next? Before jumping to Python SCAPY module to craft a packet, ARP packet, let's recap what is ARP, what are all fields available in ARP packet header. Then we will do a demo how to create a packet, ARP packet by using SCAPY. Here, what is ARP? Before jumping to it, if you learn about OSI model and encapsulation or decapsulation, you know that when two computers on a LAN wants to communicate with each other, right? What will happen, you know? So basically, an IP packet is created with a source and destination IP address carrying a data from an application. So if you imagine there is a web UI, there you enter some fields and click on submit, right? It will create an IP packet from source to destination. So this IP packet again will be encapsulated in an Ethernet frame. That means layer 2 frame. So IP is layer 3 packet and Ethernet is layer 2 frame with a source and destination MAC address. So if you remember, in IP packet there is a source IP and destination IP. In Ethernet frame there is a source MAC address and destination MAC address. So at this sending computer, right? The sending computer will of course know its MAC address, but how does the sending computer knows the target MAC address? That is where ARP comes into picture. So address resolution protocol is a protocol, network protocol, which maps network layer protocol address to a data link layer hardware address. So in our example, right, we know source IP, destination IP, and we know source MAC address, but we don't know destination MAC address. So here he will map a target IP, destination IP, with the destination MAC address. So this address resolution protocol will be used to map a destination network layer address to destination data link layer address. Let's see how it will work. In this example, in this picture above, we have two computers, right? H1 and H2. And you can see their IP address and their MAC addresses. Yes, perfectly you can see, right? But how H1 will come to know H2's MAC address? Because H1 should know IP address to send a packet from H1 to H2. But how H1 comes to know H2's MAC address? So there is no option, or there is no mandatory, there is no possible way that H1 should know H2's MAC address. But if you remember the data sending mechanism, the IP address can carry a packet from source to destination, but in order to deliver the packet to actual intended target, we should have a MAC address. Let me tell you a small example. Let's say if you are working in an organization and that organization having two branches, one is in location A and another one is location B. If you want to send a parcel or courier, what will you do? You will write a source address like from so and so flat number, so and so office, so and so landmark, or something you will write. At the same time, you will write destination as well. Flat number, row number, street number, everything you will write. And you will approach a courier service and then you will deliver a packet to them. So courier service, instead of you, they will carry the packet from location A to location B, and based on the two address, they will deliver the packet to actual intended person. Let's imagine you haven't specified a row, flat number, door number, or street number, and you just have mentioned location B. Could you imagine the courier service can deliver the package to intended person? Of course no, right? Because the particular address, the flat number or door number, which are nothing but the identity of that person, unique identity of the person, we need to specify. Then only a courier service can deliver a packet. So if you relate this example here, H1 is location A, H2 is location B. So courier service H1 address is nothing but 192.168.1.1, and office, let me repeat this. So H1 office location is 192.168.1.1. Office H2's location is 192.168.1.2. But the door number, flat number, row number, you can imagine MAC address AAA and destination door number, flat number BBB. And you can also imagine the courier service is nothing but an off service. Protocol, IP protocol. So this IP protocol, if you give him a source IP, a source MAC address, destination IP, destination MAC address, he will carry the packet and then he will make sure that packet will be delivered. But if you do not specify the MAC address of destination, he cannot deliver packet, right? Similarly, however, the professional couriers cannot deliver package to the intended person if you don't specify door number or flat number. So similarly, the same terminology will work here. But how this IP or the source will come to know that destination MAC address? How he will come to know? That is where this ART protocol comes into picture to solve this problem, right? So here, see, how does H1 knows about the MAC address of H2? We know the IP address, but we typed it, but there is no way H1 knows MAC address of H2, right? But when you use this ARP, right, ARP will send a request. It's called ARP request to a destination of broadcast. Basically, H1 knows the IP address, but he don't know the destination MAC address. But still, he don't know where the destination IP resides, right? That's why H1 will send a ARP request, a broadcast layer 2 packet, because ARP works at in between layer 2 and layer 3. It's a semi layer 3 and semi layer 2. So when H1 sends ARP request, wherever the destination IP 192.168.1.2, right, will reside, he will also receive that packet, because it's a broadcast, right? Everyone will receive. But whoever is having 192.168.1.2 will reply to that ARP request by stating, hey, that's me. So you are sending that packet to me, and this is my MAC address. That is how H1 now come to know MAC address of its destination H2 machine, and H1 will update its ARP table with the destination IP mapping to destination MAC address, and then he will start forwarding data to H2. Hope you understand how this ARP works, why we need this ARP, right? Now let's see what are all packets which we have sent just now, right? Let's see them in Wireshark capture. So this is a Wireshark capture packet. Here you can see the first one is always broadcast. So if you see this 192.168.1.1, the one who is asking who has 192.168.1.2. So he's asking this guy 1.2 by sending a broadcast message. But when 1.2 receive the message, he will unicache that packet, because 192.168.1.1, when he is sending the packet ARP request, he will mention his own MAC address as well. So sending his IP and MAC to the destination 1.2. Now 1.2 will already knows that 192.168.1.1 to its 1.1 MAC address. He will update its own MAC address in the destination, and he will reply to the sender by stating, "Boss, I am the 1.2 and my MAC address is so and so," and he will unicast that packet to the 1.1. That's why you can see it's a broadcast packet, but it's a unicast packet. So he is directly sending the packet to intended source. So if you elaborate the broadcast packet here, you can see, so this is the broadcast layer 2 address and address resolution protocol. It's a request and its a type is Ethernet type, and protocol type it's a 0800, hardware size 6, protocol size 4, is nothing but MAC address 6 bytes and protocol IP 4 bytes, and opcode, it is a request, right? Opcode is a request, and sender MAC address, sender IP, and here if you see, target MAC address is what the source is don't know, but source knows target IP address. When he send the packet, broadcast packet, this is the replay. So the sender MAC address is nothing but the actual target and target IP, and target is nothing but actual source and source IP. Now here you can see the protocol is a replay and opcode is replay, it's a number version value 2. This is how the sender will come to know the destination MAC address. Once the source knows the destination IP and MAC address, now he is ready to deliver a packet to the destination. Hope you understand the theory of what is ARC and use of ARC, right? Now we will see how we can craft an ARC packet by using Python, by using SKP module. Let's get started with the demo. So first, let's create our ARC packet and start assigning some values. So if you remember just now from the previous slide, we know, right, what are all fields are available in the ARC packet header. So here you can see hardware type, protocol type, hardware length, protocol length, and opcode, hardware source, protocol source, hardware destination, protocol description, all these fields we just now seen here. So here, so all these fields, right? So we need to populate all these fields by using SKP module. So let's do it practically here. Before getting started into demo, I assume that you already have installed Python 3 and SKP module. If you do not install Python 3 and SKP module, and let's get started with demo. So I'm going to use a SKP interactive shell by just typing SKP here, because my system is already installed with SKP and path is set. So when you execute this SKP, we will enter into Python SKP module's interactive shell. From there you can execute the commands or functions which are available in SKP. First, let's see what are all fields available in ARC. So you can simply use ls function of SKP module by passing the protocol layer here. So when you pass this protocol to ls, you can simply see that what are all the fields are available in the ARC header can be seen here. So these are all the fields which we have seen just before in the slide, and these are all required fields to send an ARC request packet or ARC response packet. You understand, right? So this is how we can populate all fields and we can send that packet. Let's get started to create an object. So let's create an object for ARC packet here. And let's see. Okay. Show. So if you see this, when you execute the show function, all the parameters or options which are available in ARC header, right? That can be seen here. And if you see this, Source hardware and source protocol source are already populated automatically by default from my local system. So KP module will take care of populating local fields automatically. And few of the types are also populated, but we have to modify the packet according to our requirement. That is how we craft the packet. So our main intention here is to craft the ARP packet based on our requirement to attack the target or to send the packet to the target. So if you want to send the ARP packet, we should have an Ethernet layer as well, right? So ARP is nothing but a semi-layer 3 protocol, but in order to send an ARP packet, you should have an Ethernet packet as well. Sorry, Ethernet layer as well. So we need to combine an Ethernet layer with an ARP layer. How can we bind the multiple protocols? If you recall the concept from KP tutorial, the slash symbol will be used to bind packet, multiple protocols. You remember, right? So here I'm going to bind Ethernet with ARP. So this is how we bind multiple protocols. And if you see here, by using show function, you can see the Ethernet and ARP are combined binded together. And if you see that the destination source are automatically populated with some random values by KP module. So we just have seen how to create set the values, right? Sorry, how to bind the multiple protocols, right? Now let's build the packet. So now we need to build. We just have created a packet. The packet contains both Ethernet and ARP headers. Now we need to build the packet. So to build a packet, if it is ARP, if you recall from our description tutorial, I mean description slide, we must set the destination to broadcast. So if you want to send a request, we must set a destination as a broadcast, right? So ARP, if you see here, the destination ether type is mentioned as some random value which is not broadcast. So that is what we are going to change here. So the destination should be broadcast. And if you see the packet, now with show function, now you can see here, so it's a destination is broadcast now, and source is the one which is a local machine source, and type is ARP. So we are sending a packet ARP, as you want type here, and hardware type is mentioned. These are all fields that can be left by default, and ARP. So who has nothing but it's a request. If you recall that the slide from Wireshark, right? So this is a broadcast packet and send who has. So this is the packet which we are sending right now. So we are asking someone who has this particular IP. So we need to send the packet now. So now, as of now, we have created a packet and you are going to send that packet. But before that, you have to see this PDST as well. So to whom we need to send? So we are going to ask who has something. The something is nothing but PDST. So we need to set PDST as well. RPKT.PDST equal to some 192.168.1.200. Let's see. So if you see our packet now, it has PDST. Now we are sending this ARP packet to this PDST by asking who has this. So now let's send the packet. So if you recall the method to send the packet, if it is a layer 2 and if you just want to send the packet, you will simply use SNP, right? If you want send and receive, we have SRP, right? For now, we will just send a packet. Send P of RPKT. Before hitting enter to this command, let's open a Wireshark and capture this packet to see what all fields we have sent here. So let me open Wireshark quickly. If you don't have installed Wireshark, please install it. It is a very useful tool to capture and analyze the packets visually. So this is my captured Wireshark packet. There you can see the ARP request and the ARP response as well. Okay, let me open this. I think it should be open now. Let me open this Wireshark. It is taking some time to load all the properties of this particular application. Okay, it's opening. Now let me close other one. One is enough. It will take a little time to initialize this Wireshark. Okay. Okay, it's been open. So I have this Wi-Fi connector, and let's see. Let me filter with the ARP here. So I'm going to send ARP, right? The ARP packet. So here I'm filtering with ARP, and if I send this packet, here you can see the packet which has broadcast and unicast packet. So this is the packet which we have sent just now. And if you see this Ethernet type, IPv4, hardware size, protocol size, and this is ARP code as request, and sender MAC, sender IP is this, and target MAC is the one which we have zeros, and this is the broadcast packet which we set all F, and this is our target IP. So here, the target has replied unicast to 192.168.204 who actually sent the ARP request. So if you see, this is the type reply ARP code, and he is sending his MAC address, so sender MAC address here. So earlier in a broadcast, we already know the source actual MAC address. Now if you see in this reply packet, the target who actually have sent this reply packet is including his MAC address now. So when actual source receive this reply from the target, he will come to know this particular 192.168.1.200 is mapped to some 186590DBE56B MAC address. So now actual source comes to know the destination MAC address. Now he is ready to send the packet to the destination. I hope you understand what is ARP, what are all fields exist in ARP packet, how to create a packet in ARP, in KP by using Python, and how to send the packet, how to analyze the packet by using SendP function, and by watching them in the Wireshark, and we can visualize the packet as well. Hope this session is very useful to you and gave you some enough knowledge on understanding IP. Crafting ARP packet by using KP and by using Python. Thank you.